Hey everybody, welcome back. Movie review time, where we basically just geek out about a movie that we just saw. That was adorable. And we just saw, I don't know what.
One Piece Gold.
Thank you. Yes, let's get back on track. And this is going to be our all the spoilers video. We're going to talk all kinds of spoilers. We're going to talk about the end, the beginning, whatever we want to talk about. So, you know, if you don't want spoilers, we have a no spoiler review. You can find the link in the description below. Or something's popping up right about now. You can click on that. And then come on back, check this out when you're ready. It'd be kind of... no, actually, you might be right. I don't know. Everything's backwards to us. But anyways, so before we get into it, let me give you your warning. Spoilers, 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 spoilers. She's doing the cat thing. It's adorable. See, I got it right that time. But yeah, so everybody's gone. You're good. You're good. Okay, just to recap real quick, you need to know that I've not seen... This is my first experience with One Piece.
Mm-hmm.
She's in the manga, but have you seen the anime? We didn't discuss that.
She's
way more familiar with it.
I don't have any idea where I left off on the TV series.
Fair enough, but you've seen...
I lost access to Cartoon Network.
Yes.
But I'm completely caught up on the manga, except for where they fast-forwarded through a few story arcs.
Okay. So point being, you're way more familiar. I really, really love this. I'm considering myself a One Piece fan now. I'll be excited to go back and restart the journey. And we talked about, you know, it's a different pace and a different level, but you're going back like 18 years.
20 years worth of material.
Yeah, but hey, as we also discussed, that's what I was doing with Dragon Ball, and that's been working out pretty well.
I think One Piece may have surpassed Dragon Ball in length.
That sounds about right. Well, I don't know, because you got five seasons of Dragon Ball, 10 seasons of Dragon Ball Z. I don't know if you count GT, but there's two seasons.
The manga's 42 volumes
altogether. Okay, I don't count manga. But anyways, we're not here to compare.
This is, I think, past 70.
Right, okay. So anyways, really, really dug this movie. You?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's basically take the most action-packed TV episode and amp it up to about 15, and there you go.
Cool. I thought the pace was fantastic. It just starts at a rocking pace and just never lets up. The music is awesome. I want to go get the soundtrack. There's some just great songs. Like, there's some surf rock stuff going on here and some like Brian Setzer ripoff stuff going on in there.
Surfing in the USSR going through my head at one point.
There was a lot of stuff that sounded like they were kind of trying to sound a little bit like certain other songs you may know but do their own thing, but I liked
that opening number, the ba-ba-da.
Yeah, all that stuff was pretty freaking cool too. God, now you're putting Cherry Pop and Daddies in my head there, but which is not a bad thing. But the designs are fantastic. I loved all the characters. You hate the characters you're supposed to hate. As somebody that doesn't know the series, there was a few moments, and if you want, we can talk about it.
Okay.
That like somebody's brother and then some villainous character that kind of, they play very small parts overall in this movie, but they show up, and obviously I didn't know who they were, but it was obvious like they were characters you're supposed to know, but it didn't hurt my enjoyment of the movie. It doesn't take you out of it. It doesn't affect the story enough, I didn't think, to be an issue. So really, this is kind of a good jumping in point for, you know, as far as getting to know the main characters and falling in love with, like, Luffy and stuff like that. So, I really enjoyed it. I like his rubber powers. That's pretty cool. And, you know, and again, I was going through the emotional gamut, too. You know, like, I was just enthralled from the opening music number and just giggling at all the kind of goofiness at the beginning. And, you know, like, they're gambling in the casino and losing the millions of dollars and be like, oh, well. But then they're, you know, taken in by the guy and they've just planted all the gold dust in them and he controls gold and shit. It's pretty fucking cool. But even then, you know, it's like there was a moment of heroics towards the end when, I guess I'm just jumping all over the place, but let's see. So basically,
the fan.
Yeah, at the fan, that was one of the major moments for me where I got a little, like, joyfully teary-eyed because, like, the moment, and you get this in a lot of good anime and mangas and stuff, of the guy who had kind of given up on life because he was trapped in there, this gambler, and he finally has the realization, Luffy helps him get it, that no, you know, just never give up, never stop fighting, as long as I'm fighting, I am free kind of thing, and I was like, God, it's so powerful, I love that kind of message. And then, you know, like, fuck, the dude at the end keeps thinking he's a god and he has all this money and he controls everybody and just Luffy doesn't give up and just tears that fucker a new one by the end and it's so fucking cool. Like, that's the thing I love about good anime is, like, these insurmountable odds and the kid who never gives up and the over-arrogant bad guy finally getting his is just so fucking satisfying. And, you know, I mean, kind of relevant to our time, too, with all the discussion that he kept being like, I have all the gold, I have all the money, I have all the power, I'm a god. You know, and it's, and like, the game is rigged, and it's the ones with the money that are always in control, and they'll make sure it's always rigged, you know, so I mean, kind of touching on some interesting things, but so what were some of your favorite parts? I'm trying not to do that thing that I do of doing all the talking, because I'm excited. The more excited about a movie I am, the more it's harder for me to leave pause points. I've tried. So tell me some of your favorite things.
Oh, I kind of like, first of all, I love all the costume changes.
They all look badass in like the all black versions at the end, too.
Oh, yeah.
Dress up stuff.
Yeah, the dress up stuff.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they have to, they're doing this plan where they're infiltrating a building and you have a group that's supposed to be, I don't know what the fuck they were thinking with their costumes.
Yeah.
It was like, I don't know how this fits into anything. I was waiting for, okay, half of them look like Korean clean group. That makes sense.
Right, they make
sense. The
other
half is like, the fuck?
Right, like, especially when they're going through the what costumes they're going to wear, and, like, Luffy's in a dress, and the skeleton guy, who is awesome, by the way, I don't know his name.
Brooke.
Was
Soul
like in a,
King.
Was in a dress and stuff. That was awesome.
Yeah, you'd like Brooke. He's a musician.
Okay, well, I like his design a hell of a lot.
Yeah. I forgot what the name of the fruit is, but he ate a devil fruit that basically made him immortal. But the thing is, if you eat a devil fruit, you can't swim. That's what the thing with the whole saltwater thing.
Okay.
That's why Luffy's like, oh shit, this is fucking me up too.
Right, yeah, because that's how they defeat the gold, is with salt water.
Yeah.
In this gigantic fucking floating city casino.
In a situation where he was stuck on the bottom of the ocean.
Yeesh.
Well, he can't die, but, you know, the flesh does kind of go away after a while.
Oh, that's kind of interesting.
Yeah.
But let's try to keep more to the actual movie, though, in case you're like me and haven't seen the series.
Sorry, it's just like he doesn't know anything.
No, we've established that, but no, it's good. You're good.
But yeah, I like the wacky race.
Oh, that was great. Yeah, even that was just, again, enthralling. Like, I know it's a movie not a lot of people love, but I fucking love the Wachowski Speed Racer movie, and it gave
me
a little...
That's actually a good movie,
right? I know. I mean, I just love that movie. But anyways, that's another topic. But I got some of the same joy that I got from some of those race scenes from this race scene. But you're right, it also kind of had some nice wacky racer element to it.
Yeah.
So that was really, really cute.
But let's see, I'm trying to think. I did like the giant gold robot, mecha robot.
Oh, yeah.
Like, and Loki! Loki.
Oh, yeah, I knew you were giggling. He has, like, this head of security thing that has this giant head, and he's like, I want to talk to you, or something. He's doing some weird things. But by the end, all his kind of main henchmen get gold armors, and yeah, that dude looked like Loki's armor. He had the helmet, so that was pretty cool.
And, but the, yeah, that's a thing, again, with, just a quick side note, with the One Piece, the guy who writes it, Oda, he likes to give characters really weird laughs.
Okay.
And vocal tics and stuff.
Okay.
So that was like just, that was nothing out of the ordinary.
Gotcha. but yeah, all that stuff was cool. The lady that could touch you and either give you luck or take your luck away, that was a cool character.
Yeah.
I loved,
Baccarat.
And what are the two main girls? It was, oh God, like.
Nami and,
it's like a C name.
Katrina, I think.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Something like that. But all their story was really, really cool, too. And you didn't know when they were going to actually be double-crossing each other and when they didn't. And like, it was. I love that it was also, too, they had to totally trick... The whole thing is, like, it's not even about winning the money. It's about trying to trick the other person, and that's how you actually win.
Yeah.
And even at the end, they had actually tricked the bad guy, but they couldn't tell Luffy the plan.
Luffy's an idiot.
Yeah, he's that character, you know. I mean, great heart. Great strength, will never give up, but yeah.
Okay. Completely random. One Punch or One Piece?
What do you mean? Are you asking which I prefer?
Well, the fight between Luffy and Saitama.
Oh. Saitama.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Luffy's made of rubber, though.
I know. But Saitama. He will atomize Luffy, I'm sorry. or tire him out or something, I don't know. But... Yeah, that is a little off topic, but still.
I know, okay.
No, you guys, what do you think? There you go. There's a good comment topic. Jump in the comments. Saitama from One Piece or Luffy, I mean, from One Punch or Luffy from One Piece fighting. Who wins?
Because we've been going, One Piece!
Yeah.
Instead of One Punch.
Right. But yeah, man, there's some other really cool stuff in here, too, though.
So who was your favorite character?
Luffy. Yeah, because I was going to say that's like maybe one thing about it is even though I got a little taste of all the characters, some of the characters did get short riffed in here. Mm-hmm. They didn't really terribly develop them. The lady with like the long black hair who can like make arms come out of nowhere.
Robin.
Yeah, like I feel like, because there was a point towards the end of the movie I saw her again and I'm like, wait, I don't even remember this character until she did the arm thing again. I'm like, oh yeah, that character was in here.
Well, that's kind of normal for her. She's very calm and laid back and she's like, yeah, I'll go do the thing.
Yeah.
I'll fix things as we go along. Yeah.
I like the guy that was in love with all the cute ladies.
Sanji.
Yeah, that's probably me. until I found the one cute lady. But, oh God, what else? There was some good stuff in there, though. I like the snails that were like...
The transponder sails?
Yeah, is that like just for that place?
No,
or is that...
No,
okay,
that
so that's a thing.
Prevalent throughout the universe.
All right. The owls, the laser eye beam owls, the motion sensor owls.
I think that was just from the movie.
Well, that was really cool, too. Especially because when the skeleton guy...
Yeah.
I'm bad with names.
Brooke.
He's the one that gets caught by them for the motion sensors, but they can only see things that are living. So, like, dude, you're not living. It's fine. You're good. You're not giving it away. So that was pretty cute. The design of the city and everything is really, really phenomenal, too. The whole massive gold and Vegas. Maybe want to go to Vegas for sure.
This is one of those things where it's kind of like, because it's a movie rather than manga, I know Oda had input on it. I just don't know how much of the design he was actually responsible for.
Okay.
But yeah, it all the character designs all totally fell within his parameters.
I just don't know about
the city itself, although I could see him doing it.
All right, well that's good. Yeah, I mean, there's some I really enjoyed it. I think there's maybe a few more things to talk about, so let's take a quick break and we'll come back and finish this up. We'll be right back. Okay, so back to it. You had a question.
So, with all the powers running around on the screen, what was your favorite, aside from Luffy?
Right, well, I mean, and I don't know his my power was my favorite, because I liked his character the most, but I'm really interested. And one of the things I'd like to see more is the three-sword technique guy.
Yeah.
And the idea of three swords, that he's, you know, he's running a sword in each hand and one in his mouth, you know?
Yeah.
Like, that's... Okay, yeah, let's see that. That's pretty fucking cool. And then he's fighting that dude who likes pain.
Yeah, the masochist.
He's like bashing in the giant dye tumbler cup.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, and anytime you hit him in the head, you're like, yes, I love it more. Give me more. Like, and even they're like, oh, I think they even said something like, man, you really are a pervert.
Yeah, Frankie called him a pervert.
Yeah, so that was pretty funny. And I guess, Frankie's the one that loves all the ladies, so him.
No, Sanji.
Oh, okay, never mind.
Frankie is the cyborg.
Oh, okay. Wait, there was a cyborg?
Yeah, the guy with the big hands.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He's a cyborg.
Yeah, duh. Sorry. I was thinking of this one other underdeveloped character because I didn't get any sense of him at all. I think it's probably the only other dude on the crew. Like, human-looking dude, maybe.
Big long nose,
the
slingshot thing?
Oh, slingshot thing, right, okay, yeah. That's true, he was the slingshot thing. But I think he was one of the ones that got a little less play than anybody else. But the slingshot
actually,
thing was kind of cool.
Actually, he got a decent amount of play.
Okay, well, maybe he just didn't resonate enough with me yet. You know, maybe I'll get more out of the anime and stuff, so.
Well, he's one of the early on characters, so.
Okay. But yeah, I would go with a three-sword guy. But also, too, Frankie the cyborg is a really interesting character, and I would like to know more about him. And you know what his hand reminds me of? Some of you guys probably remember this, but there was a Swamp Thing 3¾ action figure. I think I still have mine somewhere. And it literally had a hand that would separate, and it had, like, a piece of string, like, it was a spring on it, so you could, like, have his hand shoot out and grab things and grapple up and stuff, so I thought that was kind of fun.
Yeah, and actually, going back, Zolo isn't exactly what he does, isn't exactly a power, though. That's a technique.
That's true.
And he can do the Heiki, when you saw some of the characters' arms or legs turn black, it's a special technique.
Okay.
That multiple characters can do.
Okay. Yeah, and they don't really go much into people's powers or anything either.
Yeah,
I mean,
they kind of expect you to either already know them or to pick up on them.
Right, and I mean, you can follow the story without knowing, but I'm certainly kind of left a little intrigued at certain things. Like, I'm going to learn more about that one day.
Yeah.
Some of the things Luffy could do and everything.
Like, they didn't do as much with the Chopper as they could have done.
Yeah, again, is he a shapeshifter maybe?
Because it looks like he's a reindeer shapeshift who ate the human fruit.
Okay. Man, this show sure is fruity. That was a bad joke.
So, but he's actually the ship's doctor.
Okay. Yeah, because I want to learn about him because I've got his flocked pop figure.
But he has these things called rumble balls that let him transform into different versions of himself. Like, he has, like, speed versions, strength versions.
Oh, that's not what my rumble balls do. he really is a pervert. Yes, I am.
But when he's, like, the tiny version with the big head, that's, like, his normal version.
Okay, yeah, and that's the version I'm familiar with because I had seen the pops and everything, so... All right, yeah, I was definitely more curious about him, too, so you're right. I think he also he had some great moments, like, you know, some comedic moments, but he wasn't very well explained, but...
Yeah, he tends to be a comic relief character.
Yeah, and again, they didn't really need to explain much, because the movie is very self-contained story. It very much is a who's going to trick who overall kind of heist thing at the end.
The thing is, I'm not sure how I would have reacted to it going in cold, because I would have spent a lot of time going... Fuck.
Well, that's a good question, because when we walked out, she said she's anxious to see my thoughts in the reviews, and now I'm curious, because, like I said, I didn't really have too much trouble following other than a thing or two.
The thing is, I think I could have followed it, but at the same time, I'm the same person who's going watching King Kong going, no, that can't work.
Right, but yeah, but I do suspension of disbelief very, very well. That's why I think I'm so awesome.
Like, I could have followed it, but I would have a lot of questions. Mm,
yeah, well, are you surprised, though, about how well I took it then, or
I'm
about
bit.
Where you are? Okay, well, good.
I was just like, I expect that you there's a lot of stuff that you're like, okay, whatever.
Well, I mean, that's kind of what it is, because any of that stuff, it's not... detriment. It's not that important to the plot of what's going on for me to not suddenly be confused about what's happening in this movie, you know. So I wasn't bothered by it, because I knew going in there were going to be things I wouldn't understand or pick up on. So small crowd, not huge, but you know, but it's been playing for a few days.
Yeah,
so.
This is the third and final show that we went to.
Yeah. Now, and I know you want to talk about this, so I'll just set it up. But there were. There were some mixing... Well, I mean, you may have more to say about this than what I'm going to say, but there were a few mixing issues towards the end, and it may just be because they had to hurry or something. But towards the end, when all the shit's hitting the fan, everything's mixed so loud, there's a couple lines of dialogue that's like, wait, what? What'd you just say?
Actually, it's more than that. Basically, okay. I could really use subtitles anytime they're doing a special attack.
Ah, okay.
because usually it's like... Okay.
I see what you're saying.
I think I know what that was.
Right, yeah, I see
you. I'm not entirely sure.
It's not Goku's, Kamehameha.
Like, Luffy was doing fourth gear at the end, but I'm not sure if he said that or not.
Okay.
Because I couldn't understand half of what he was saying at that point.
Fair enough. Well, especially at the end when he was doing certain power attacks, because, like I was saying, it was very loudly mixed, or the dialogue was lost in the mix. So.
And then Sanji's special attacks are French, so I'm like, oh.
Yeah, that doesn't help. But yeah, so overall, has that pretty much got you there? What you want to say about it?
I think so.
Cool. Well, I mean, overall, I really
had a lot going on in this movie.
There was, but and at the same time, it's very simple. So I mean, I appreciate that. It's I think if you're a fan, you're really gonna love it. You're just looking for a fun time.
Actually, I'm thinking now I need to get you to watch some of the Lupin stuff.
Okay. Well, I mean, you know, in my copious amounts of free time, as someone likes to say. Did you just flip everybody off? She was like...
Who, me now?
What did they do to you?
I just have a scratch in my
eye. No, I know. I just caught it out of the corner of my eye. But anyways, so we really like the movie as a newbie and an old school fan. So I think anybody can enjoy it. If you have any interest in this, highly recommend seeing it. It'll be out on Blu-ray, DVD, all that stuff eventually. Or Funimation, Crunchyroll, all that kind of stuff probably. So check it out. Comment away. Let us know, have you seen it? Did you like it? What's your favorite part? Who's your favorite character? Any of the questions we ask in here, particularly what's your thoughts on Saitama versus Luffy.
Luffy. Got me doing
I know, because I had been saying it wrong until I heard it
Monkey
pronounced right
D.
in
Luffy.
Here. Luffy. All right, but so do that. Comment away, geek out with us in the comments. You can also click the thumbs up button, give us a thumb of encouragement, because we do love to be encouraged. We're going to get out of here and I guess watch some more movies, and we will see you guys later.